This is Ben from Compete Themes, and in this WordPress beginner tutorial, you'll learn how to password protect WordPress posts and pages. You'll start by using a simple method that doesn't require installing any plugins, and then I'll recommend two plugins you can use for much more advanced password protection. Let's start with the simplest approach now. Log into your WordPress dashboard and navigate to the page you'd like to password protect. I'll just click on the Pages menu now, and once it loads, I'll click on the sample page I've published as my example. Inside the post editor, you'll see this status invisibility section in the sidebar, and take note of the visibility status. The word public on the right lets us know that this page is publicly viewable, and this text here is actually a button that you can click to reveal the visibility menu. Inside the visibility menu, you can make the post private or password protected. Click on the password protected option and you'll see this text field appear. Enter your password here. I'll just type in Ben as my password and then click anywhere outside of the pop-up to close it. Lastly, remember to update the page and then when you view it, you'll see the password form displaying instead of the content. If you enter the correct password, the page will reload and the content will then be visible. WordPress's built-in password protection should work well for most cases. However, if you need to password protect your entire website, sections within a page, or you need multiple passwords for a page, then check out this plugin called WordPress Password Protect Page Plugin. There's a link in the description below if you don't want to type that all out. And one last recommendation, if you have a password protected page and you want to hide the sidebar or specific widgets, then try out the Widget Options plugin to get these kind of display controls. There is a link to that plugin in the description below as well. That's everything you need to know about password protecting pages in WordPress, and if you enjoyed my tutorial, then make sure to subscribe so you can catch the next one too. If you have any questions, please post in the comments section below, and thanks so much for watching.